Hello everyone, I'm here to deliver a presentation on the topic Pure Aloha and Slotted Aloha. My group members are Ankita Borkar and Kamini Dehlikar. Contents: Meaning of Aloha, Basic Idea, Versions of Aloha, Pure Aloha and its Analysis, Slotted Aloha and its Analysis, Summary, Reference. Introduction. Aloha word has been derived from compound of Hawaii words. Alo means share, ha is a sense of life. Aloha is a family of contention protocols. Contention is a media access method that is used to share a broadcast medium. In contention, any computer can transmit data at any time. First come, first serve. The AlohaNet solutions was to allow each client to send its data without controlling when it was sent, with an acknowledgement. Retransmission scheme is used to deal with collisions. Basic idea behind Aloha. The hub machine broadcasting packets to everyone on the outbound channel, various clients' machines sending data packets to hub on the inbound channel. Use of two distinct frequencies in a hub and star configuration. Before we start the presentation, it is very essential to know what is Aloha. Aloha is nothing but a multiple access protocol. There is a shared medium in the diagram that we see. We can call it as Ethernet wire. There are different stations which are used to transmit different frames having various constraints. Versions of Aloha. There are two types of Aloha, Pure Aloha and Slotted Aloha. Pure Aloha is original version of Aloha. Slotted Aloha is a modified version which is division in time slots. Pure Aloha. Whenever a station has a data, it transmits. Frames are transmitted at completely arbitrary times. Sender finds out whether transmission was successful or experienced a collision by listening to a broadcast form of destination channel. Sender retransmit after some random time if there is a collision. We see in a diagram that there are four stations in Pure Aloha. When someone is transmitting the frame, others should not transmit. If this happens, there will be collision. As we can see in the diagram, the frame 1.1 is transmitted successfully. But as soon as frame 1.2 starts transmitting, the second frame also transmits at the same time and there is an occurrence of collision. This collision can take place between two or more than two frames at this duration. So this duration of frames is called as collision duration. Procedure for Pure Aloha. Station has some data to set it with its counter key equals to 0, that is k equals to 0. If station A is transmitting its frame to station B, to know that I got succeeded, B need to send an acknowledgement. TP is maximum propagation time and 2T into ACK should be there. If ACK received, then transmission was successful. If ACK is not received, we need to implement the attempt. If first attempt failed, try second attempt. Then k equals to 3. The cycle continues to go on till k reaches its maximum level. K equals to k max is normally 15. K has a maximum value of 15. If k is less than 15, then we have the range that is 0 to 2k minus 1. That is 0 to 2 to the power k minus 1. Where k is number of attempts. Randomness helps in removing the collision. Here TP is maximum propagation time, TFR is average transmission time for a frame, TB is back off time. Analysis of Pure Aloha. TF is frame time, that is processing, transmission, propagation. S is average number of successful transmission per TF, that is the throughput or efficiency. G is average number of total frames transmitted per TF. D is average delay between time a packet is ready for transmission and the completion of successful transmission. We will make the following assumptions. All frames are of constant length. The channel is noise-free. The errors are only due to collisions. Frames do not queue at individual stations. The channel acts as a Poisson process. Since S represents the number of good or succeed transmissions per frame and G represents the total number of attempts transmitted per frame time, then we have S equals to G, that is probability of good transmission. Vulnerable time of pure Aloha. We see there are frames in slotted Aloha also. So in this figure we can notice that it is susceptible to collision. Station A, from time t to transmit time tfr, it is written as t plus tfr. If someone has started earlier, then there is no collision because length, that is tfr, is more. If someone started after time, then there are chances of collision in the end. Sometimes t plus tfr leads to collision. Therefore, this A's beginning time to C's beginning time, and from starting, the time, that is 2 into tfr, is called as vulnerable time. The probability of having k arrivals during a time interval of length t is given by pt of t equals to lambda t to the power k e to the power minus lambda t upon k factorial, where lambda is the arrival time. The vulnerable time for a successful transmission is 2tf, that is collision probability increases. So the probability of good transmission is not to have an arrival during the vulnerable time. Pt of t equals to lambda t to the power k e to the power minus lambda t upon k factorial. And setting t equals to 2tf, that is frame time, and k equals to 0, we get p0 of 2tf equals to lambda 2tf to the power 0 e to the power minus lambda 2tf upon 0 factorial, that is e to the power minus 2g, because lambda equals to g upon tf. Thus s equals to g into e to the power minus 2g. For pure Aloha, the probability of a successful transmission is e to the power minus 2g. Expected number of transmission equals to e to the power 2g, which means that a small increase in the channel load, that is g, can drastically reduce its performance. The throughput for pure Aloha is s equals to g into e to the power minus 2g. The maximum throughput, s max, equals to 0.184 when g equals to 1/2. The Aloha protocol is an example of an unstable protocol. Now we come to slotted Aloha. Slotted Aloha was invented to improve the efficiency of pure Aloha, as the chances of collision in pure Aloha are very high. In slotted Aloha, there is still a possibility of collision if two stations try to send it at the beginning at the same time slot. Slotted Aloha still has an edge over pure Aloha, as chances of collision are reduced to 1/2. Procedure for slotted Aloha. While there is a new frame A to send to, send frame A to the slot boundary and wait for acknowledgement. If after some time ACK is received, successful transmission of frame. If there is a collision, the node detects the collision before end of the slot. Wait a random amount of time and go to 1 and end. This is a flow chart. Frames in slotted Aloha. First frame take TFR time. The rule is station can transmit only at starting time of slot. Slot 1, 2 and 3, there is no collision. Station 1 and 2 send packet at the same time. Slot 4 and 5 works fine. So vulnerable period equals to 1 TFR. So we can see the improvement is there as compared to pure Aloha. Analysis of slotted Aloha. Suppose n stations have packets to send, each transmits in slot with probability P. Probability of successful transmission S is by any specific single node, S equals to P into 1 minus P to the power n minus 1. By any of n nodes, S equals to probability S equals to NP 1 minus P to the power n minus 1. For optimum P, as n tends to infinity, S equals to 1 upon E, that is 0.37. So we can conclude with a summary. Aloha is one of the random access protocol implemented at link layer. Chances of collisions are made in pure Aloha as compared to slotted Aloha, but still it is least efficient as compared to other random access protocols such as CSMA, that is CD/CA. These protocols work efficiently when there are less active nodes. Modified versions of Aloha are being used in some services such as mobile slotted Aloha. References. Thank you.